Hello friends, myself Ravi. Welcome to our channel. In today's video, we will take a brief look on the introduction of Angular. So without getting late, let's get started. So the obvious question that you will get is, what is Angular? Next, why is Angular? Next, you also need to know the history of Angular. Okay, so let's get started with what is Angular. So Angular is an open source JavaScript framework written in TypeScript. Angular is a framework that provides you a lot of facilities to develop web application. Okay. Angular is also used to develop SPA application. So the full form of SPA is single page application. Now let's know what does this SPA means. Let's open Chrome and type angular.io, which is the official website of Angular. If you see this website, if you click on feature, on the same page, this content gets updated, right? If you click on doc, the page is same, the content gets updated. If you click on resource, in the same page, again, the content gets updated, right? So this is what SPA means. In SPA application, we don't need to open new page to update the content. Okay, we can update the content on the same page. Okay, now again, let's go to slides. The next thing that we want to know is, why will we use Angular? So we have a lot of frameworks and libraries which is used to develop the single page web application, like we have React, we have Vue.js. But why will we use Angular? So Angular provides you modular approach, which also provides the clear code structure. So you can divide your application into different modules, and it will make your life easier to do the development of your web application. It also provides you the clear code structure. Angular comes with component-based architecture. So you can create components which you can reuse so that you don't need to rewrite your code again. So Angular provides you the component-based architecture which will help you to write reusable code. Angular comes with lot of inbuilt features, like it provides you routing, it provides you HTTP client to deal with the HTTP requests. It also provides you lot of different type of facilities which will help you to develop your application quicker and easier. In Angular, you can use Karma and Jasmine to write your unit test cases, and unit test cases helps you to develop your application which is bug free. Angular was developed by Google in back 2010, so it has backing of Google, and Angular uses TypeScript for its development, which is backed by Microsoft. So Google and Microsoft are the trusted source. That's why you can rely on the Angular for your development of single page web application. Now we also want to know about the history of Angular. Okay, so Angular was developed as Angular JS back in 2010, when the first Angular version was released. Angular was developed by Google, but several years later, after its first initial release, the landscape of web development started to change. New advancements and standards in JavaScript emerged, and Angular started to get left behind. So, in 2014, Angular came with Angular 2. So, in 2014, Angular 2 was released. Then, Angular 3 was skipped, and after that, Google always upgrade the Angular version 2 times in a year. One is in March and another is in November. So, in March 2017, Angular came with Angular 4 version. In November 2017, Angular came with Angular 5. In March 2018, Angular came with Angular 6. In November 2018, Angular came with Angular 7. In March 2019, Angular came with Angular 8. In November 2019, Angular came with Angular 9. In March 2020, Angular came with Angular 10. In November 2020, Angular came with Angular 11. In May 2021, Angular came with Angular 12. In November 2021, Angular came with Angular 13. While shooting this video, I will be working with Angular 13 in my later videos. So, I have started this series on Angular to provide you a brief idea about the basics of Angular, and also I will go from basics to advanced concept about the Angular. We will see how we can implement Angular data binding. We will also see how we can transfer the data between the components. We will see about the Angular forms and validations. We will also see about the HTTP services. We will see about the observables. We will also learn about HTTP interceptors in upcoming videos. If you have any doubt regarding anything, you can comment below. I will definitely try to answer your question. If you haven't subscribed our channel, please do subscribe our channel to get more updates. Thanks and have a nice day.